When are aliens going to get in touch? The human race is really eager to hear from aliens. We've thrown dozens of missions into space in an attempt to further our reach and to see what's outside our solar system, but as yet, we've had absolutely no response. We've even created an organisation called SETI, which stands for the Search for Extraterrestrial Intelligence, in order to scour the universe for stray signals and communications from advanced civilization. So why aren't they texting back? Well, you have to appreciate, first of all, just how big the universe is. If you grab a penny and you put it on the ground in front of you, imagine that that penny represents our star, the Sun. If that's the case, then the next nearest star, Alpha Centauri, would be 350 miles away. The same distance from Newcastle to Brighton, or Milan to Rome, or just a quick pop to the shops in Australia. At this scale, our galaxy, the Milky Way, would still be 7.5 million miles across. Remember, the Sun is literally the size of a penny in this model, and that's 30 times the actual distance between Earth and the Moon, and this is without even getting into the size of the universe as a whole. Given this scale, it's no surprise that whatever neighbours we have aren't exactly next door. After all, that our universe is believed to be around 14 billion years old. It contains over a billion trillion stars, that's 21 zeros, and is still growing. The universe is expanding at various rates, depending on where you look, which means our neighbours might even be moving further away from us as we just try to reach them. It could simply be a question of geography. One of the most famous aspects of the search for ET is the Fermi paradox, named after its creator Enrico Fermi, who in 1950 asked the seemingly simple question, "Where is everyone?" His line of thinking was that given the Milky Way is 10 billion years old and 100,000 light years across, meaning light takes 100,000 years to travel from one side to the other, if another civilization had invented space travel that could reach even 1% of the speed of light, they surely would have colonized our entire solar system 100,000 times over. So surely the fact that they haven't tells us nobody's there. Our home planet Earth is actually a very special planet, and not just because it's where we live, it's what we call the Goldilocks planet. Not too close to the Sun, not too far away, but just the right distance to provide the right level of warmth and radiation to encourage the growth of life. A life-sustaining planet would also require water and an atmosphere balanced in such a way to support oxygen-breathing life forms and of the right density and thickness to protect the surface of the planet from harmful radiation, which in turn requires the planet to be of a certain size and mass, and with a relatively balanced orbit and rotation to provide a relatively consistent amount of light and heat to a large part of the surface. Some planets can spin very slowly and some go around very quickly. Some only have one side of the planet facing their sun at any given time. So there's a huge number of factors to take into account when you think about a planet that could sustain life. And we also need to consider time as an important part of communication. As I said, our universe is very old and it's still growing. Humans have existed on Earth for a few 100,000 years and we only invented the radio in the last 100 years. And if we're holding out hope to hear the call of another species, we're working on the assumption that not only are they intelligent, not only are they broadcasting, but also that they started broadcasting hundreds, if not thousands, of years ago. The invention of broadcasting technology also brings with it the creation of other powerful technologies like nuclear energy, and comes along with a global warming and possibly overpopulation and the exhaustion of natural resources. So it's possible that only a few generations after developing the necessary technology, a civilization could have wiped itself out through disaster, natural or otherwise. It's worth considering the sad possibility that there is advanced life out there in the universe, that they've seen us and simply don't want to talk to us, like a nuisance caller that you just let go to voicemail until they leave you alone.
Our planet Earth is a beautiful example of life. We have humans, animals, reptiles, insects, and plants. Do you think there's any other planet like ours that has life? Do you think aliens exist? Welcome to YouCurious, and today we'll be looking at the top pieces of evidence that prove aliens exist. Ancient evidence of aliens in cave paintings. The 10,000-year-old rock paintings found in the Kurama region of India depict spooky, faceless aliens and an antennaed object that looks just like what we now see as a UFO. 9. The UFO painting and art history aliens. During the Renaissance, eerie UFO shapes popped up in works of art on several occasions. This is the Madonna with Saint Giovannini, also known as the UFO painting, most likely painted by Italian Renaissance artist Domenico Ghirlandaio from around the 15th century. 8. The Nazca Lines. The Nazca Lines, located in southern Peru, are a collection of over 10,000 lines etched into desert sands. They form around 300 geoglyphs of various images depicting animals, figures, and plants. What's truly incredible about those geoglyphs is their sheer scale, some of which stretch over more than 9 kilometers and measure 30 meters wide. Due to their sheer scale, many consider that these Nazca lines must have been created from an aerial point of view, insinuating that aliens must have been responsible. 7. Crop circles. We've all heard of crop circles, and most would consider them to be a pretty modern phenomenon. However, the first publicly recorded crop circle was way back in 1678 in Scotland, which came to be known as the Devil's Circle. Crop circles are often large and complicated in their design, and they tend to be found in fields of wheat or corn where the stalks are bent into sophisticated shapes. 6. Foo Fighters. No, not the band. Surely you must have wondered where they got their name from, right? Well, Foo Fighter was a term used by Allied aircraft pilots during World War II to describe strange aerial sightings believed to be UFOs in various accounts. They were described as glowing fiery lights speeding through the air, or sometimes quite close to the ground. Researchers have suggested that Foo Fighters can be explained as electrostatic or electromagnetic phenomena. However, there are no conclusive accounts as to what these sightings were, and the cases remain a mystery to the present day. 5. Physical evidence. There are such things as trace cases or close encounters of the second kind, what's defined in UFOlogy as instances where there is physical interaction with a UFO. This might be a landing mark, damaged vegetation, or weird residues. There are somewhere between 3,500 and 5,000 trace cases. As with anything UFO related, often these trace cases can be debunked as hoaxes, but some, to this day, still prove very difficult to explain. 4. Project Sign. Project Sign was an official study under the United States Air Force put in place to investigate UFOs. It ran from 1948 to 1949, but was kept secret for years. The investigations undertaken by the project were intended to debunk speculations that UFOs had extraterrestrial origins. But of the nearly 13,000 sightings that were studied, 701 of them simply couldn't be chalked up to weird weather or man-made objects. In the end, the government simply had to classify these as unidentified. 3. Area 51. Area 51 has been the subject of many conspiracy theories over the years, mainly due to the controlled secrecy surrounding it. It was used to design and build military fighter jets and drones. However, conspiracies still persist regarding its alleged use as an alien research center. But why Area 51? It would be of no surprise for any government to have a research center for extraterrestrial life, and the extremely controlled site in the Nevada desert makes it the perfect place for such alien research to happen. 2. Martians are our neighbors. When we think of aliens, very often we think of Martians, our nearby neighbors from the planet Mars. The main reason we look towards Mars for extraterrestrial life is because it's the closest to our own planet with a somewhat similar environment. The main similarity being that there was once water on Mars. Recent evidence shows that approximately 4.5 billion years ago, 1/5 of the planet was covered in water. In 2017, the Curiosity rover detected the presence of boron on Mars, and boron is something that's considered an essential ingredient for life. 1. The Drake Equation. US astronomer Frank Drake developed an equation to estimate the number of planets that were capable of hosting life and also capable of communicating with us. In 1961, he put together this equation looking at 7 key factors, including how many stars have solar systems, the formation rate of those stars, the number of planets that could support life, and how many of those planets could form intelligent life. The figures used are debatable, but Drake calculated there to be approximately 10,000 possible intelligent species in our universe. Looking at everything together, there's not much concrete proof to really prove that aliens exist. However, I think you'll agree there's more than enough there to pique our curiosity.